Hello, everybody. Thanks a lot for coming. I see a lot of friends, and I'm very touching. Thank you, Carrie, to discover that I exist and founding me. Your words are very inspiring, and I agree with a lot of things I heard this morning. As artists, I'm convinced we should ask more to museum and rethink about what museums can be, what is the public sphere, what means engagement, participation, what people will need, what could be our role. Of course, my very humble experience is to join hundreds, sometimes thousands of people all around the world in a very big participatory project. And more than telling about that, I would like to show you something which I think is more useful. But just let me introduce two or three things I consider important in this process. There are a lot of approach to the public sphere, to the communities, the participation, and I make a very important difference. I see a very important difference between collaboration and participation. And maybe that's the reason, the key point of the success of our projects. During the years, I realized, because my background, which is music and classical music, movie set in a professional way, and also art and didactic, because I was professor for several years in different universities around the world, I realized that the core structure of work is what fits more with me. It doesn't mean that's the only approach we can have towards art or artistic practice, but the role of the activator, the role of the artist that can activate without providing solutions, by the way, but just proposing something, could be a chance, and that's the chance I took some time ago, very long time ago, actually. I guess around 15 years old, I decided to work this way. And the core structure of an orchestra or a movie set, when every single member is not changeable with another one, because it's not just a competence, a skill that we share, but it's the background of these people, what this person concretely means, what he or she saw, her or his background, the story, everything in a very generous way can be activated and shared with others. I want to mention the first project I prepared for you, just a very short trailer, so I hope to don't bother you too much. It's the most ambitious project we made so far. It was an opera, a long-term project made in 2012 between three countries, Germany, Spain, and in United Kingdom. And it involved more than 20,000 people. People were involved for the entire year in the different locations to learn to be script writers, to learn how to use the camera, to write the script. And we are talking about not professional writers at all, not professional dancers, not professional camera operator, and so on. So they negotiated with us the role they wanted to have, what they wanted to achieve in this project. And the result is Rosas. Guys, please, the file number one.
Thank you. clubs and so on. Unbeknownst to her, really, at that point, she finds herself around about the city centre.
Possibly get involved in script writing as well.
It's not a provoking question. I want to ask you a question.
I want to be a film director.
Wow.
That's what Rosas, and thank you. I guess it was quite important for our practice to show, because it introduced all the other topics we would have worked in more in the future. As you saw already, during the casting session, people negotiated the role they want into the project, what they want to achieve. Sometimes they want to be formed in a specific discipline, like camera or sound or what else. Other times they want to get involved in the writing session. We are talking about not professional writers, so you can imagine how many things they share with us, and in a very generous and open way, sometimes also not avoiding conflicts. They share with the others during this session. They share their abilities. So sometimes they don't have enough time to be trained as actors or dancers or musicians or what else. So they just decide, for example, in the case of school of hairdresser or local restaurant, to offer their own job as something to just a little piece for the project itself. Other topics as the music performed by non-professionals as well, band, brass band, basically retired workers, brass band. That's another important point for us. Well, finally, all this process involved so many people. And after Rosas, we realized that a lot of citizens wanted to go ahead with the group that already were formed into the several different locations, and they wanted to continue their work together, not always, not all together, because of course life is life, so they can love and they can detest themselves in a very short time, but they decided to continue very often. So that's why we created the School of Narrative Dance, which is a platform, an open platform, a school that focus on storytelling, a platform that people can use very freely. And this school is already 1 year that we travel all around the world, and we are invited by institution, museum, university to make a very different work, focus on different ideas of didactic process based on emancipation of the students, where the teacher, and of course, the teacher can be also an illiterate person or unemployed or not a scholar. Sometimes they are, sometimes not. Well, the teacher is an activator of a process of self-training. That's what we did, especially focused on dance, because the first project the school was confronting itself were carried out with a lot of illiterate people. There are a lot of illiterate people also in Europe, but it's something that society try to hide, community try to hide very often. So the Western society at least tried to do that. So the dance, intending as dance, not the athletic gesture, but just another tool for the storytelling, was actually the only language we could share with a lot of people. But the school of narrative dance is also an excuse to adapt itself to the different community we work with. And it's, as I said, it's an open platform, so it never exists the same school in two different countries. The outcomes, the entire experience itself is completely different from a country to another. Actually, we already worked in Italy, in England, in Belgium, in Switzerland, in Ecuador. We will approach very soon Israel, and all these aspects, since it's a not building-based school, free of charge completely. So even the teachers can offer as a service for their own community their skills and their abilities, even just for one day. So it's completely free of charge in both aspects, completely no profit. So guys, please, file 3. It's a brief trailer about the school and the work we made so far. Thank you.
Cioè, se noi la misurassimo con uno strumento in questa stanza sarebbe esattamente uguale in ogni punto. Questa è la caratteristica della luce diffusa. Non c'ho fretta, fatelo con calma. Non esiste sbagliare, nel senso che dovete solo capire come si fa. Cercate di farlo in modo sicuro e poi questo con questo in due tempi, perché questo ha il suo peso, questo ha il suo peso. Questo sicuramente lo potete portare a due da qui.
Shoulder and
vincere, portare a sé. Io narro perché voglio prendere la vita e me la voglio mangiare e la voglio gustare più forte. La vita ha un sapore più forte se io ne ho coscienza e se io la scrivo, la leggo, si intensifica la mia esperienza mentale, no? Mi succede così, vero?
Okay. That is just very short introduction to the school. As you saw, the school is open to everybody, no limits of age or knowledge, nothing at all. And that's just one detail, I miss it, and it's quite important for me to share with you. All the teachers are local energies we found in the place where we work. I mean, we could have a crew of very good professional working and traveling with the school, but it will be an abusive role of the artist and of the project itself. So what we try strongly to do, which means a lot of work, but we are very proud of, it's to find in the location where we have to work, people can be teacher, of course, participant. So sometimes a housewife can discover that his neighbor is very good at making photographs and he becomes the photographer, the teacher about still photography for one day. That's an impressive power we can find in a community, and that's something that really links people all together. I finished my time, guys, because I see 13. Probably we don't have time for the last video. Well, okay. Do you want to watch the third one? Okay, so the third one is about where you are nice, thank you. I like politeness. We can show the last file who concerns all the other work made with the community of miners, Lower East Side residents, something we really enjoyed with the people. I see the amazing face today between you, between the audience. So please, guys, the file number 2, I guess, which was actually the last one. And then I disappear, and thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for your attention.
Federica Di Mattia. Ciao Federica.
Salve.
Quanti anni hai tu?
Devo compiere 79.
Di cosa si occupa o si è occupata?
Ho lavorato un po' a tutti i posti. Ho lavorato un po' anche in maniera poca, non ne troppo.
Tata, hai un obiettivo, un desiderio?
No, non vedrebbe fare questa esperienza.
E tu come ti chiami?
Io Salvatore Soletti.
Hai nemmeno sentito dire queste cose, vero?
Sei di Enna, sì.
No, di San Cataldo.
Città mineraria. San Cataldo è un paese dove c'erano molti minatori.
Io non sono minatore, ma ho avuto esperienze da bambino da minatore. Avevo 7-8 anni. Facevo la spola dal paese a portarci da mangiare o dell'acqua, quello. Assoro, sempre Assoro. Il nostro è un paese di minatori.
Camera operator, not professional sound engineer, so people that just train themselves. And the script is original idea of this community of miners, all of them illiterate, by the way. So they wrote the original idea helped by students of the different community, University of Sicily in the south of Italy. And this is a radio drama written by workers and retired workers of Marghera, an industrial district near Venice.
Quasi ogni sera faccio un poco di flessione per non arrugginirmi del tutto. E poi col calcio smaltisco un po' di tossina. Ho ricevuto la cartolina da casa che mi ha fatto sapere delle sue scorrerie nel sud. Via d'Adriana, che anche qui mi sono mangiato qualche volta i peoci.
It is in the perspective that I reckon we have to try to position our key messages.
If you want to learn, you have to study. It will take 10 years, but then you can say, I get it. When a person wants...
Weaknesses. I remember everybody's weaknesses. I had a really smart mate. He seemed really strong because he did a lot of wrestling. He felt like a character. Excuse me, he was a character. I didn't look
in front of a girl.
I looked embarrassed because I was embarrassed.
New York.
Probably $6,000.
He wants to be cool. He wants to be, like my teacher says, is clicks.
Mm-hmm. A cat, a t-shirt.
There's so many possibilities for a story there because
session.
We live in a city where there's literally every type of person imaginable. I love collaboration. I think that's something I miss, like, because being a writer is kind of a very solitary thing, and I like working with other people to create something.
And here they want to train themselves in other roles, and they share their competences and their ability with the other participants.
Okay, here's a little story about a man named Basil and Adrian Gold and how chemicals can kill. He had a plan to make millions of dollars and it could turn out bad, but easy for him to swallow. So he proceeds to conceive a plan that's still formless. First, he would kill a man, and that he did. Left Mr. Gold by the way to leave the car in the river so it could be found later. Now, here's the twist. As he crossed the bridge, he heard applause and cheers. He's confused. Instead, a policeman asked him who he is and says he wants $1 million just for crossing the bridge. But as he did so, his photo was in the car. Newspapers would have him exposed by the mall, and it all ends a way Basil never thought. He stayed in the car as the cliff he drove off.
Sustainable economy, 1,200 citizens offering just 1 euro and producing this piece. Madrid, mostly retired war crafty people, retired seamstresses. The history was written by an entire neighbor at the outskirts of the city.
Those passing by. It bothers him that they touch him, they grab him, that they hug him.
Original song.
During hours of cutting his grandfather wanted this place, mustaches and hair. Can't stand him on the boys, goes his away. Grandfather loved this place because his ears will be closed.
The first participatory project of my life.
One of those days in which everything may happen.
I remember I looked at the sky, and so nothing.
I was so tired.
So many really strange things may happen in a lifetime.
I was so tired.
Him, he was making a big mistake, and it surely regret.
In the future, thinking of the past. When I came back home and changed for dinner, I found a telegram. I was
simply lost the sense of time. He stopped recharging the clock.
I finished. Thanks a lot for your attention.